Hey guys, before the video starts, I just want to give you a little bit of a heads up because this video has no real building in it. We're not really adding anything to the zoo. I'm just placing down a bunch of trees and stuff and beautifying the place. But what I am doing is asking a bunch of questions and asking a bunch of feedback from you guys. If you're not interested in that and you're only here for the building, then you can skip this episode. It's not going to offend me. It's up to you. But if you are interested and you do want to give me some feedback to the questions that I've asked this episode, then you can continue on watching. Okay? Hey guys, you're watching one and only. My name is AJ. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Build a Zoo. Today, I found out what it would be like if I was Donald Trump, because I have gone and put the wall all of the way around the zoo. I used the little test part of the wall that we built together and just copied that design all the way around and then just made some very basic corners to make it all blend in. And I tell you what, for some reason, it's made the zoo 100 million times better. Just putting a wall up, there was a part of me that didn't want to do the wall because I knew it was going to be a pain to do. Even with World Edit, even with copying, pasting, I knew it was a big area. It's a large area to put a wall around. But I thought, I said I was going to do it. I'm not going to let everybody down, so I'm going to do it. And I'm so glad I did. Where's it all gone? Because it just makes it look, I don't know, it finished off. It's not finished, but it makes the park look more refined by having this wall that goes all the way around. I also have read your feedback from the previous episodes asking, what do we do with this series? Do we stop it, or do we finish beautifying it all and some trees and make it look nice? Do we finish it and start something else? Or do we go into the unrealistic animals, the dinosaurs, the stranger ones like that? And surprisingly, the result actually truly did surprise me. You guys want it to continue. You guys want me to do the unrealistic mobs. And I 100% didn't expect that. I thought you were going to say, no, move on to something else. I don't want dinosaurs or anything like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to spend a couple of episodes or whatever finishing this place off, making it look really nice. And then we're going to have an entrance, or an exit if you like, out of this park and into a hidden area, into like a monstery area with dinosaurs, with the animals that didn't suit in this zoo but will suit in a more mystical zoo, with the wyverns and the dinosaurs and the dragons and things like that. So I was thinking about, I don't know exactly where we're going to have the entrance. I was thinking maybe off the penguins would make a lot of sense, in as though the path already somewhat lines up to it. We poke a hole in the wall, we make, I think I want like a hedge archway that you go through and it goes into like a big jungly area, huge tall trees where we can then find the larger animals. Now I don't know if we're going to do them in pens like we have in here, they have to be pretty big pens, or if we just let them roam free. Now there might be some problems with letting them roam free. They might attack each other, there might be hostile ones. Like how the sharks attacked all the other fish inside the aquarium, there might be something similar that goes on around this Jurassic Park of the zoo that I'm planning on. So yeah, I don't know. We'll have to see. But I'm pretty excited. Palm trees? No, I don't want palm trees. I might have some birch trees though. So the first thing that we need to do is dress up the perimeter now. Where the wall is, where there's space that we aren't going to be able to utilize for anything, we're going to want to dress it up with some stuff. Oh, look at the rain. Weather clear. So, I think I don't want any trees here. I think I just want to extend the lawn there. This doesn't have too much room. We need like little bushes and bone meal and stuff like that. But definitely here we can fill up some of this spot. What is that? Oh, that's a bee. Hey there, little guy. Are you okay? You're not anymore. Okay, so let's put some... I might as well not bone meal it, to be honest. I might as well just put the saplings down, let them grow by themselves, especially for oak trees, since they're not picky about where they grow. When we want to grow spruce trees and stuff like that, I think I will force grow them because we all know how picky they can be. We have some nice trees around this part. Fills up that space nicely. I think we'll stick to the perimeter for the moment. And then we'll go around later on. Once all the trees are sort of grown. Add bushes and stuff like that in place. Now, I don't want oak trees here because we've already got a nice oak tree perimeter around these penguins. So I think we're going to go to, I think, spruce. So they make a difference. Birch trees have very similar leaves. So I think if we go with spruce instead. And we just fill up this area. Yeah, this would make a really good entrance, I think. I really like the height of the wall as well. It's not so tall that it like casts this huge shadow, makes you feel penned in like a zoo animal. But it shows the border. It shows when you're close to the edge. It shows that you're not missing any enclosures if you walk by. Now, people have also been asking, can we get a world download, AJ, for this world? Now, I can. I can give you a world download. Not a problem. But you guys aren't going to get the animals. You're only going to get the map itself. Because obviously the map I can upload and give to you, give a link to you guys to download like I do with the City series. But you're not going to get any of the animals, any of the strange mods that we have in here, any of the spawn eggs or anything like that. It's just going to be vanilla. Unless you download all of the mods yourself and install them all for, you have to install Forge yourself and stuff like that. Now, it's not that hard to do. Obviously, if it was hard to do, I wouldn't do it because I'm not that good at doing at modding and stuff like that. And I figured it out. I watched some videos on YouTube when I first started doing modded series and figured it out pretty quickly. So it's definitely not hard to do. It's 1.7. And you can just download. In fact, I've had some people on Facebook pretty recently asking me where to download Forge, where to download this mod, where to do this. And I've been able to help them through Facebook. So if you guys are interested in that, then what I might be able to do, I can't just upload like my entire file with all the mods as much as I would like to, because it would make things extremely easy for you to download and play, you know, if I just was able to upload the whole thing. But I can't do that because of copyright. I don't own these mods. I own the world, so I can upload that, but I don't own the mods. And I'm sure, even though the mods themselves are very old now, and Minecraft might not be as popular as it once used to be, I don't think the people that made these mods will appreciate me just uploading them to to you guys to download. I don't think that's fair. I wouldn't want that. Look at all those bats. I wouldn't want that. So I'm not going to do that. I can't do that. It would be illegal for me to do that. But yeah, it's the same with the City World. I know a lot of you have downloaded the City World, and although that's not such an important thing to have all the mods for it, because at least you get all the buildings and stuff like that and you can build upon it. You don't have any cars if you download that world either. But yeah. What I might do then to help you guys out, if you guys did want to download this world, and I might do it with a City World as well. I might be able to, no promises, but I might be able to upload a or like in the description have like links to every single mod that I've got. I did have that, I think at the beginning of the City series, I had that. So, hey Crab. So I had a link to each mod, but as the list grew, I forgot to update it, and now I think the mod list is probably most likely very outdated. I just want trees along here, and then I want to have lawn here. That needs to be changed back to grass again. Wand. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. If you guys want to be able to have all of the mods, let me know in the comment section. If there's enough people that want it, then I'll happily do it, okay? Let's put that there. Beautiful. Fill in these random holes that were never fixed for some reason. Yeah, so trees down there, and I'll stripe the lawn down there. I don't want to fill the trees up absolutely everywhere, just in places where there's no point or there's... Look at them spin. I don't know why I find that so funny. I just do. We'll put some spruce trees around here. I'm trying to... Oh, no, we'll put birch trees. We'll change it up a little bit. Birch trees down here. I'll try and keep them in line for this area as well. So I'll have them all the way down. And this way. So we need some ideas. Need to think, start thinking about this new Jurassic Park area as well. Like I said, I might have... where do I want to go with these? I don't want them to go all the way down there. I want to use spruce trees from here. I don't know if I want to have it an open area or if I want to enclose it, each animal in. There's a lot. Well, not like a ton. Not as many as we've got in this zoo, but there are a fair few animals. We might be able to have enough time to have a look through at the end of this episode to see what mobs we've got available. So maybe you guys can come up with some interesting enclosure ideas. I think I probably want to leave this relatively open here. I don't think I might not even want to stripe the lawn there. I might just bone meal all that once the trees are grown, obviously. And then just bone meal all that up. And the same over here. And then behind here, I might do a little bit of lawn striping. So I think we probably want to put some sort of fence in, like along here. Like that. So it's striped on this side, bone mealed on that side. I think that'd look pretty neat then. Ah, yes. I always forgot about these little zones here. We need to just put like some little grass or like some little trees in there. I've always forgotten about that. I always go, yeah, I need to do that. And then poof, goes out of my mind and never comes back. Let's, is that in line? There we go. We need those ones down and these ones down. Little hedge just continues on a slight bit, not too far. Something like that. I think it just sort of makes it a little bit neater. I might do the same on this side as well. And just bring this path down. Like that. Keep it in line. I think that looks pretty neat, right? No trees down this side or this side. I'll probably stripe the lawn this side, bone meal it this side. I think that would look really neat. I do want to put a little bit of a hedge corner on here because it's very open on this area. Like that. I'm going to put one more there. Might as well. And then I want a tree from here all the way to the end. I don't want to use jungle trees because the jungle trees are going to be very heavily used in the Jurassic Park area. So I don't want to confuse this side with that side. We can just go with oak trees down here. And I'm going to stagger them two blocks like this. Oops. It makes a really nice pattern when they grow. It looks really neat. Oops, that's really close to the wall. That's better. And there might be some more fences that we need to put down, like around this area and stuff like that. I just don't know. Until the trees grow, it's going to be very hard to actually tell. And then around here, this is sort of a more of a farmy area. I might as well use... I might go with birch trees. I think I like the trunks of the birch trees around here. So we want to line around that path there so people don't walk that way. And then come around the back of the... Oh, it's so funny when they're so like boss-eyed like that. It's like a really cute puppy, isn't it? Okay, so that should look really good behind there. I know I might actually just add trees all the way behind this, to be honest. Were you still using the right one? Yeah, birch. I think this would look actually better as a little mini birch forest behind here. No point bone mealing behind here. It's not seeable or anything, so we might as well just use the space up by filling it with trees. Now, I don't think that there's many areas on the inside of the map that needs to be worked on. And if there are, they're very, very small areas, like this little area right here. I think we could probably do now. We'll grab a little fence. I don't need any stone brick underneath it. And we'll just run these along here. Fences, cobblestone walls, hedges, everything like that will be used to just sort of tidy up these little areas on the inside. And then once all the trees grow, we can then do the same thing on the outside. Anything more? No, not on this side. That'll be a striped section, striped lawn section there. This is going to be another striped lawn section, but I'm going to go with a cobblestone wall for this side. Down here. Now, you know how... Oh, man, I've asked you so many questions this episode. I don't know if I really should be asking you even more. I was thinking, you know how at the end of any series, I always do one more episode of touring it. Usually, I'm not talking in it. It's just got a nice piece of music to it. And you just get to watch it. Do you know what I mean? And I was thinking, you know, seeing as though this series will be finishing at some point, not for a little while longer than I thought, because obviously we're doing the Jurassic Park part. But how do we end off this series? How, like, at the point where everything is 100% done, how do we end it? Do I do my normal montage of different shots and panning across enclosures, or do I do something a little bit different? I was toying with the idea, and I don't know how well it will work or if you guys will enjoy it, but I was thinking about doing like a zoo tour and just walking around the zoo very quickly. It'll be edited. It won't just be one long cut. It'll be edited. And when I get to each enclosure, I just say one weird or strange fact about that animal, something that you might not have heard before. I think it could be pretty cool. But I don't know. I need your support for that, your support for those ideas. And if you like it, I might do something like that. If not, I'll do the sort of normal world tour style finish, just with a nice piece of music. I don't mind doing that. I like that kind of ending. If I didn't like it, I wouldn't do it on all the other series, would I? But anyway, how are we getting on with this? I want to go around to where we first started in a moment and check how those trees are getting on, just so it gives us an idea on what the rest of the zoo is going to look like. Oh yeah, and these little parts. You know, I might make these water. I think making this water could be pretty cool. If we... that one to that one. Replace grass with water. And then put those underneath there. And these underneath here. Then it makes it look nicely part of the building. But... makes it look a little bit more interesting. Lily pads. Lily pads. And I'll keep those bushes on me, because I might put some bushes. Maybe. No, I'll do them floating above the water. I know it looks a little bit weird at first, but I don't think it's really going to make too much of a difference. Can I get under there? There we go. Yeah, I think that looks okay. And we'll have another little one down here. Looks a little bit weird when they're floating, but it makes sense in a... in a weird way. I don't know why those bats are spawning. That's annoyed me since they started to spawn. One, that one, to that one. Make that into water. And make this into orange. Oops. That likely messed up some stuff. Probably just like, yeah, I see a pink carpet there. That's okay. I'm not bothered about that. Okay. Other things that are basically finished but not quite finished. Things like the hospital, you know how, or the veterinary clinic. We've got like a couple of different rooms in there, but there's still some space. I don't know if I will finish that off. I might be able to do it off camera, I suppose. But I certainly won't be doing any more of it on camera. Because it'll just be repeating the same thing. It'll just be like having two episodes doing exactly the same thing, which just makes no sense at all. I might just leave it there or finish it off camera. You guys know basically what the entire thing's going to look like anyway. But anyway, how are these trees getting on? We've had quite a few grow, actually. It's given us a really nice idea. There's a nice clump there. I really like that clump. I think this needs a tree in the middle of it. Can I grow a spruce tree with bone meal around it, or does it like count it as blocks? I know these trees are like really picky all the time. Yeah, see what I mean? Oh, no, it did grow. It did grow. It just took like a little while. The tree in the middle there just sets that off really nicely. But yeah. See, look already with these trees now, especially like the spruce trees in the corner, some trees over there. It's starting to close all off. We can see the birch trees. Everything's starting to fill in 100%. So to finish off this episode then, because we are pretty much out of time, I think we should go through some of the mobs that we should really add. We'll just sort of hover over them here. I mean, we could have spiders, creepers, and skeletons, but that'd probably be like a last thing. Like we can make a creeper pen. It's definitely possible for us to do. Same with all of the other sort of hostile mobs. Would hostile mobs attack other hostile mobs? Maybe not. Mammoth, definitely one. Treant, definitely one. Mummies may not be. Sandworm, they're pretty big. From what I can remember, sandworms are actually like large in this. There's the bears, polar bears, gorillas. No, these are all animals that we've already got in here. Minotaur or Minotaur, whatever you want to call it, definitely one that I want to have out there. That's exactly the kind of mob that we want. Giant rat. I might add those ones as well. They could be pretty cool. Draugrs. I don't really class Draugr as like an animal. It's more of like a It's a person, isn't it? It's more of a zombie, and I think it makes quite as much sense. The boom doom do the bloom doom is just a rose bush, like an alive rose bush. Centipede, depending on the size of the centipede, I might add that. We might have another go at some fish over there, maybe. I don't know, but we'll like make them so they don't despawn at all. Ogre, 100%, yes. I think in horse there are those horse dragons or pegasuses, whatever you want to call them, as well. So we might be able to get those in there. Werewolves. I think we're actually using werewolves here, but they're or W wolf. I think they're classes as werewolf because they're so big wolves or white wolves. So we don't need those in the new area. Scorpion, 100%. One of those scorpions are huge. They look really cool as well. Some of them even have babies on the back that are animated, pretty like crazy. I wonder if I could scale animals. Like if I placed the mob down and then used the MBT editor, could I like double the scale, so I might could I make it twice as big? I'll have to have a look into that between episodes. These golems do not spawn; they actually suck up blocks nearby. They'll like rip my wall to shreds. Wyvern is like a dragon, and yeah, that'll do. These are just like the first page of mobs. I do have more mobs down here as well that I'll need to go through, but yeah, there's some ideas. That's where all the dinosaurs are in the second one as well. I think it'll work. That's where I'm going to leave it for this episode though, guys. Next episode, I don't know, we might start on the new area. We'll see. There's some finishing off that we still need to do in here, but I just ran out of time for this episode. If you enjoyed it though, hit that like button. If you haven't already, then feel free to subscribe. We shall see you in the next episode.